So I just got my first ever YouTube strike after having a YouTube channel for, oh gosh, like 15 years or something, pretty much since the beginning. It's for a video that I made, me and my buddies made years ago. It was just a joke. After we found out about the whole bacchabazi phenomenon, we did a video making fun of it. It's one of the most disgusting things I've ever heard of. I think anybody who actually practices this should be dealt with accordingly. But it's not something I condone, obviously. So YouTube gave me a strike. They said, it was for protecting children or whatever. So I responded. I sent the link to the original video that I had gotten the bacchabazi dance off of, off YouTube itself. So just like a lot of other YouTubers, I'm like, why would you strike mine when the original is still here? It's 10 years old and has 1.5 million views. I just found out that this is, there's been another round of YouTube censorship. Markiplier and some other well-known channels are going through the exact same thing that I'm going through now. So now I just kind of want to do a cursory glance of, and I know you've, seen heard this kind of thing before, but now I kind of just want to do a glance of, what is allowed on YouTube? What's totally fine on YouTube? So let's just type in real quick, 10-year-old pole dancers here, and wow, a lot of stuff comes up. Wow, you have this mulatto girl from Ukraine. She seems to be very popular. Okay, this one of her seems fairly sexualized. Looking through a lot of these videos. Whoa, this one's got a lot of views. That probably because it's funny. We'll click on that one in a minute. But just scrolling down the list here, you can see that there's a lot of views on some of these. I find it very interesting that these videos with the older ladies and the videos with the really, really young girls don't seem to have as many views as the more teenage girls or the really like fancy gay looking guys seem to get a lot of hits too. So that to me seems fairly commensurate with the idea that sickos and pedos are using YouTube essentially as their Pornhub. So we're just going down the list here. Oh, this is also interesting. The videos that are sort of shaming you for being into this, that are seem like they're sort of calling into question watching a 9-year-old gyrate on a pole. Those views don't seem to get as many views. Oh, here's another one of a lady who's taught it for like 10 years and has a lot to say about pole dancing. Her video didn't get very many views either. Seems to me that if people were legitimately interested in pole dancing as a sport, that the ones with these older ladies who are renowned experts who've been doing it for decades and this one with the lady who's teaching it, seems like they would have a lot more views. But if it's really just about like softcore teenage girl porn, then you would expect there to be a lot more views for the channels and the videos that there are a lot more views for. Then there's this one that, oh, they warn us is a bit naughty, clearly pornographic. And now again, I'm not trying to call out pole dancing as a sport. I think it's fine. I understand why you want like a short, younger female, at that confluence of strength and flexibility doing this kind of sport. I totally get that. I have nothing wrong with a room full of girls pole dancing as a sport. That's fine. But is it something that should really be videotaped and put on the internet for all the sickos of the world to gawk at? Moreover, some of these, especially in America and Great Britain, you just can't separate pole dancing from stripping. You can't. And then when you have these videos where like a 6-year-old girl is wearing what looks like a stripper's outfit, well, it doesn't even look like you're trying to separate pole dancing from stripping. Now, again, I understand that for a lot of people, it's a legitimate sport. It takes a lot of talent and effort, and that's great, and I have no problem with that. But obviously, it's being used as a sexual exhibitionism for people that want to stare at this kind of thing. And that apparently isn't victimizing children. That apparently isn't abusing children. But apparently, me making fun of bacchabazis and the sick, twisted people that practice that, apparently that is. So YouTube is messed up. We have these far-left media companies completely monopolizing the public square. I have no idea why they're entitled to constitutional protections, but they don't have to obey the Constitution. It's insane to me. I think that we all just need to migrate away from it, go to VidMax or whatever. But YouTube is over. It's over. They've made their deal with they want to just be the next TV. They don't want to be the alternative to TV like they started out. They want the big advertisers. And they've done everything they can to lie and manipulate and turn YouTube into a money-making machine for the few rather than the many. They're never going to let PewDiePie make $12 million in a year ever again. We all know what's going on. It's sick, it's twisted, and we all just need to leave. Oh, God. Oh, God, no. Why? Why? Who is this for? Who the fuck is this for? Why was this ever on video? This is just wrong. It's wrong.
Emma Haslam.
Can I ask your age, Emma?
I'm 27.
Okay.
And where are you from?
I'm from Derby.
Are you married?
Yeah, I'm married and I've got a three-year-old daughter.
And I see a pole, I see a skimpy outfit.
I'm trying to promote pole fitness is not for the usual sizes. I'm a bigger lady. And I'm just hoping that people will just see that I'm good at what I do.
All right, Emma, best of luck.
Well, let's hope that's not a support beam.
Yeah, it's pretty clear I ain't no size 2, but I can wrestle, and I can throw you, 'cause I got that boom boom that all the fighters chase. All the right punches in all the right places. I'm an Olympian trying to make the top. We know that Jones ain't real, come on son, make it stop. If you're a foodie, just raise him up, 'cause every inch of me is perfect from the bottom to the top. Yeah, my mama, she told me don't worry about your size. So she kept feeding me Popeye's chicken, those legs and thighs. You know I won't be no stick figure lightweight, you know that's wrong. So just slide me that funfetti icing and move along. Because you know I'm all about that cake and chicken. I'm all about that cake and chicken. I'm all about that cake and chicken. I'm all about that cake. Because you know.
It's the way you look that's putting us off.
Yeah, you're really good. It's really great. Yeah. I'm not just saying it's good out of social pressure to be cool with fat chicks. No, it's really great.
No one would pay to see you perform.